Hey my friends, what's going on? I'm back with another video and today we are talking about the Fiutech G6 gimbal for your GoPro Hero 5, Hero 6 and other action cameras. So let's jump right into the video. Now, as some of you may know, I actually had the predecessor, the Fiutech G5 for my GoPro Hero 5, and I shot a review about this gimbal as well. And there's a link to that video somewhere here in the corner, so please check that out. At the end of the day, I wasn't necessarily too impressed by this gimbal. I had my issues with that, so I just sold it at one point. Now, with the Fiutech G6, I'm really hoping that some of the issues that I pointed out have been fixed. So first of all, let's have a look what's inside that box, and then we have an even closer look at the gimbal itself, its features and how it works. Not that it matters much, but I really like the straightforward and simple design of the box. It really does look nice. So let's open it up and let's have a look inside. Now first thing, we have a bit of an upgrade over the Fiutech G5, because this one only came in a pouch, and here we have a more substantial carrying case. Now the case will definitely give you more protection for your gimbal, but I think the pouch was easier to travel with. I could just take it with the gimbal, throw it in a bag and pretty much take it anywhere. Now first of all we have the usual paperwork, I believe some instructions and guarantee cards. Yep, that is exactly what it is. I don't need this at this point, so let's put it aside for now. As with the previous version, some accessories, the battery and the gimbal itself. Now first of all let's have a look in this little box to see what comes with the gimbal. Now we have a pair of shorter screws which allows you to mount other action cameras on your gimbal, so it doesn't necessarily have to be a GoPro Hero 5 or Hero 6. A micro USB cable for charging the gimbal and a proprietary small cable to charge your GoPro through the gimbal. But it's nothing that we need at this point, so let's put it back into the box so we don't lose anything and let's move on. So next we have the 5000 mAh 3.7 volt battery, which gives you a runtime of about 12 hours. At least that's what Fiutech says. It's probably slightly less, but that is something that I will have to test first. So, and now to the star of the show, the gimbal. So first of all, let's take these lashes away so we can get the gimbal out and let's have a closer look at it. Now right off the bat I can tell you that the gimbal feels great. It feels very solid, substantial and the rubber grip feels very, very good in my hand. I mean overall just holding the gimbal you can really tell that this is a quality product. Let's take away the protective foam of the mount and let's see how that looks like. Yeah, it's very similar to the previous version. Over the years, Chinese products have become really good and products like this one here can really compete with the best. So let's put the battery inside and let's fire this thing up. Now putting the battery inside is very easy. We just screw off the bottom of the gimbal, then we'll take our battery, just make sure that the protective film is removed before you use it, and then with the plus side first, into the gimbal, the bottom back on, and that's pretty much it. Unlike its predecessor, the Fiutech G6 now has a standard tripod mount at the bottom, which is great. So you can use it with a tripod, you can use it with a monopod. If you need that extra reach, you can use it with a selfie stick, and you don't need to buy proprietary accessories in order to get that flexibility. So you can just use what you have, and I really love that. Now mounting the GoPro on the gimbal is rather easy. We just loosen or unscrew the retainer bar. Let's put it aside for now because we don't need it. And there are essentially two ways to mount the GoPro. This is the conventional way, which means with the mode button against the motor. That doesn't allow you to turn on and off the camera, but it gives you access to the USB in case you want to charge the camera or you want to plug in an external microphone. You can also mount it upside down, which doesn't give you access to the USB, but you can turn on and off the camera. I prefer the conventional way because I can use quick capture or I can turn on and off the camera via voice commands, and I really prefer having access to the USB. And then we put the retainer bar back on and that's pretty much it. Just make sure that it's tight enough so the GoPro doesn't come off. You don't want to tighten the screws until the plastic is cracking either, so just take it easy. Now let's have a look at a feature that I absolutely love, and it's probably one of the best upgrades to the gimbal, which allows you to balance the camera. Just loosen the knob ring and then you can balance the camera by shifting the cross arm left and right. When you're done, tighten the knob ring again and you're done. Now, as I said earlier, you can charge the GoPro with the gimbal using that tiny USB cable that comes with the gimbal. Now, as you can see, on the one side USB-C, on the other side micro USB. I really don't understand why we can't have USB-C on both sides, but hey, what can I say? Just remove the side door of the camera that gives you access to the USB. And then we just plug in the USB-C side of the cable into the GoPro, as I'm showing you now. And now on the other side, right next to the motor, under this little rubber ledge, we can plug in the micro USB side of the cable. And that's pretty much it. Just remember, you have to turn on the gimbal in order for it to charge the camera. But otherwise, here you go. So enough talk, let's turn on the gimbal and see what it can do. So we hold the function button until the animation fills the whole display. You will hear a sound and we are ready to go. Now let's start by talking buttons and physical controls. And first of all, under the display, we have a joystick that allows you to very easily move the camera left and right or up and down. And if you have the gimbal on a tripod like I do here, that allows you to create very smooth footage. Under the joystick, we have the function button that allows you to toggle through the different modes. For example, a triple tap makes the camera lens rotate 180 degrees into selfie mode, but we talk about the different modes in more detail later in the video. And then under the function button, we have the capture button that allows you to start and stop recording once we have connected the gimbal to the camera via Wi-Fi. And with the camera connected to the gimbal, you can use the settings button here on the side of the gimbal to switch the interface for camera parameters or camera modes. And below the settings button, under that little rubber cover, we have the micro USB socket for charging the gimbal. At this point, I want to draw your attention to another huge upgrade to the G6 over the G5, and that is the angle of the motor. This 35 degree angle allows for two things. First of all, it gives the camera more space to move, because remember, one of the main reasons why I couldn't recommend the G5 was because it was so easily hitting the camera. And the other advantage is that the motor doesn't obstruct the view to the display anymore. So this is really a great upgrade. Now let's look at the front, and here we have two controls. First of all, we have the trigger button that allows to enter the lock mode or reset the camera position. And above that, we have the horizontal adjustment button that allows us to tilt the camera regardless in which mode we are. And then finally on the side, we have a standard thread mount on a flattened surface that allows us to mount accessories to the gimbal. It could be either a holder for your smartphone to use it as a viewfinder, or you can mount an external microphone to the gimbal using one of these Coltrue mounts or adapters. Now a quick introduction to the Fire On app, which connects to the gimbal via Bluetooth, that connects to the camera via Wi-Fi. Everything is being connected. That gives you a lot of control over the camera, the gimbal, and how you want to shoot video. It is awesome. In the default mode, you can point the GoPro pretty much anywhere. In the course to follow mode, the GoPro is allowed to pan left and right. Vertical tilts or rolls are restricted though. And then in the lock mode, the GoPro stays in its current orientation. All panning, tilting and rolls are restricted. And there's the restoration button on the very right, which resets the position of the gimbal and with that for the GoPro. In rolling, you can tilt the camera, and with the app, you can also switch the camera modes. Now let's have a look at the different gimbal modes. The default mode is the panning mode, which means horizontal movements get smoothed out. However, the camera will always remain leveled. If you move the camera up and down, it will always stay horizontal. A double tap brings you into the follow mode. Here the roll direction is fixed. However, the camera now moves according to your left and right movements and up and down movements by smoothing it out, obviously. A triple tap and you're into selfie mode, so you can shoot your beautiful face and record yourself speaking to the camera. And then a double tap on the trigger button and you are back in default mode. Now a single tap on the function button and you're in lock mode. Here the orientation of the camera is fixed. It will always look in the same direction regardless of how you move the gimbal. A single tap again and you're back in panning mode, the default mode. Holding down the trigger button will also activate lock mode, and if you let go, you're back into the default, the panning mode. So at the moment I am outside and I'm just here to shoot some test footage for you to give you an understanding as to how the gimbal works and what the gimbal can do for you. Now, one big advantage, simply because you can balance the gimbal or you can balance the camera, you can act actually an accessory to the camera. And at the moment, the external microphone adapter is attached to the GoPro. You can't see it, but you can obviously hear it, because normally the camera would pick up all that gimbal noise, and hopefully with my external microphone attached to the gimbal, it works just fine. But how to do this, this is a subject for another video. Now this is it, my friends. This is my review of the Fiutech G6 gimbal for your GoPro Hero 5, Hero 6 and other action cameras. And in my opinion, if you're currently in the market for a new gimbal, this one is the one to get. It has some great features and improvements over its predecessor, the Fiutech G5, and overall a very solid gimbal that definitely delivers. Now, if you like this video, please like and subscribe, because that helps me and helps the channel grow. If you have any questions or feedback about this gimbal, just leave a comment down below and we'll help you guys out. And with that, as always, I catch you guys in my next video.